star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave.
And that was Skylar Cole singing the national anthem, a fantastic rendition. Happy Halloween, everybody. Trick or treat, it's the NBA. We're glad to get spooky with you tonight. And tonight, we'll see the Dallas Mavericks as they go up against the Orlando Magic. Kevin Harlan with you, joined by Doris Burt, Greg Anthony, and David Aldridge reporting courtside. A look at the starting group for the Magic. At the forward position, it's Wagner and Bancaro. Cole Anthony is out there with Terrence Ross. And it's Carter in at the five down low. And for Dallas, inside form will be Finney-Smith and McGee. The backcourt pair will be Doncic and Dinwiddie. And it's Bullock in at the three. This game will probably be something of a chess match, don't you think, Greg? Both these squads love to run intelligent half-court strategies.
Yeah, you can expect to see some interesting playmaking as these squads try to open each other up and create opportunities to score.
And the Magic start out with the ball. And here is Anthony. Carter with a screen on Doncic. Anthony finds Carter. Basket is good. He'll get a chance for one more at the line.
Let's remember, Wendell Carter Jr. goes about 6'10", 270. Good luck trying to stop him without fouling.
And Wendell Carter Jr., Greg, one of the better rebounders in the NBA.
And Kevin, his numbers kind of sneak up on you. I mean, great job of clearing the glass and getting the break started. Still underrated as a rebounder, but is making a name for himself.
And with all the youth of this Magic team, you feel like, Doris, they are on the verge of something big.
For their fan base, Kevin, you certainly hope so. What you're really looking for is maybe the breakthrough that the Cleveland Cavaliers had last year. A textbook job of rebuilding with youth and quality trades. You have to stay patient and understand this is a process.
Here's Anthony after Luka Doncic's bucket. McGee with the block, and he gets it back. Here's Ross. That's in there. Carter with the assist.
Well, what an excellent finish by Terrence Ross. The defense giving him a very hard time, but he was determined.
And you love seeing that great mobile one drive a second time.
And that's what a coach loves to see in a close game. Just put your head down and make something happen.
Now, here's Dinwiddie. His last outing with 20 points. Doncic left side. And they double up Doncic. Dinwiddie wide open. Bangs home the trifecta.
Yeah, because Luka Doncic is such a threat to score it, it opens up the passing game, and boy, it is on display right now.
Now here's Anthony. Here's Wagner. McGee with the block. Doncic against Ross. And they double up Doncic. For three, Bullock. Another three for Dallas.
And he's not going to miss that sort of an opportunity from deep.
And with an update from the sidelines, Let's check in with David Aldridge.
I briefly spoke with Jamal Mosley. He's looking for his guys to put up a terrific performance tonight, especially at the defensive end. He said, we want to use our length and athleticism to protect the rim, make it hard for shooters to get clean looks. This is the first meeting of the season between these two. Guys, we'll see how it comes out.
Interesting report, David, looking to set the tone defensively. Greg, they don't really want to shoot up.
You know, I expect them to be aggressive closing out on shooters and blocking out on that defensive backboard.
Well, those are great points, and they're things you really want to establish right out of the gate. Talk about hitting the ground running, 4 for 5 to start.
They need a good offensive possession.
Yeah, they've gone a long time without a bucket.
Down low, Hanchich with the steal. Dinwiddie outside. Pass to Bullock. There's a good screen. Lock at 6. Off target from 3-point range. So for Dallas, their last game, a loss to the Thunder. Now Anthony. Pass to Carter. Inside. They need this. And finished off by Bancaro.
Boy, what a great find by Carter Jr. Not a ball-stopping big man. You gotta love it.
First quarter of action, just under 3.5 minutes played. To the paint. It's stolen by Bancaro. Ross passes to Carter. And then Carter with the dunk.
It doesn't get any easier than that, guys. Carter Jr. gets the position he wants and goes to town.
On the wing, Doncic, covered by Anthony. McGee is screen on Anthony, 13 feet away. And Doncic gets it to go. Doncic has got his second basket.
Good way to start this game. You want to get him rolling as early as possible.
He's a guy who, if he gets hot, he can carry your offense for long stretches.
Now, here's Bancaro. No good. And the Mavericks going the other way now. They come into this one following a loss to the Thunder.
Scoring efficiency was an issue in that one. Took them too many shots to get their points.
I think it was a lot of bad decisions leading to a lot of poor looks. Patience was not their best quality in that basketball game.
And the way he was able to reach out towards that release had an impact.
Well, no question. He altered that shot. And most of the time, that's just as good as blocking it.
Now here's Anthony. Nothing yet on the scoreboard for him. Boss against Dinwiddie.
2 minutes remaining in the first.
Here's the lob to the hoop. Shooting foul as the whistle blows. He'll shoot 2 free throws. It's on Paolo Bancaro.
Really the right play defensively. If you can't block, force him to the line.
It's his first trip to the line.
Shoot 2.
Throw good, Bullock. You know, there's lots of basketball to be played, Doris. However, for teams off to a cold start, is it time to panic, or when is it time to panic?
It's never time to panic, Kevin, because that is not going to advance your cause. I think you have to look analytically at what's happening. Do you have key guys out to injury? How many new guys do you have on your roster? Is there something in particular contributing to your tough times? But it's never, ever time to panic.
And so Bullock nails both of them. The Mavericks, GA, have been trying to tighten up their defense the past few seasons, and it's beginning to show.
And we're seeing signs that the players are getting the message, and they're spending more energy at that end of the floor, and that's essential for any elite team.
Over in the corner, Wood. The pass to Ntilikina. Kina. to Wood. Dallas again missing.
And you could tell he thought that triple was going to fall.
Hardaway against Harris. To the wing right side. They could use a bucket. Here's Bamba. Ntilikina with the rebound. So it's Ntilikina who brings up the ball for Dallas. Leading by five. To the inside. Passes to Bull. Powell against Bamba. Powell kicks to Ntilikina. Takes the three. Runs off. He starts the game with a miss. Now, here's Hampton. Tight defense on him. Harris outside. Lays it up off the glass. There's 21 seconds left here in the opening quarter. Hardaway against Harris. Hardaway with it. He's gotten some minutes, but nothing on the board yet. Pass to Ntilikina. Three-pointer. Dallas again missing. So at the end of one quarter of play, still a close game. Mavericks ahead. They're up by three. And back with the start of the second quarter in just a moment. So far, we'll see if either of these teams can jump out in the second quarter. And guys, what's your take on the Mavericks so far?
Attacking, drawing fouls. They won that first quarter at the line.
They have done a tremendous job of drawing contact and putting officials in a place where they simply have to make the call.
On the court for Orlando, they've got Bamba. Terrence Ross is out there with Anthony. Then there's Wagner, and it's Bull in at the four spot. Now here is Hardaway. Here's Wood. It's deflected.
And that massive wingspan coming into play there. Bull uses it to perfection to block shots.
And while we've got a moment, let's send it over to our terrific reporter, David Aldridge. David?
Thanks very much. Orlando has a very young roster. Coach Jamal Mosley says, one thing I've said to them is dominate the simple. The more we can keep it simple, the better we'll be. Not overthinking, just playing off instincts and reaction. Kevin, back to you.
The place to start makes a lot of sense. David, thanks. Now, here's Wagner. He's been quiet so far, still no points in the game. He feeds it to Bamba. Anthony up on top. Deep two from Ross. And the rebound goes to the Mavericks.
And this is a shot he can definitely make, and the defense not a factor at all.
Finney-Smith kicks to Powell. The three for Doncic. The Mavericks rebound. Pass to Finney-Smith. Dallas moving the ball around. Six to shoot. From outside the arc. And that's good. Luka Doncic for three. Doncic has got the lead up to six now for the Mavs. The Magic shooting a lackluster 38% for the game, struggling so far.
And what blows me away about Doncic, the consistency across the board.
GA, for three straight years, he was selected to the first team All-NBA. And that's all before he turned 24 years of age. Do you have any idea how hard that is to do? What he has done is incredible.
Here's Hardaway. Bull Bull making his last shot. The pass to Wood. It's blocked. And that's out of bounds. Dallas will retain possession. And we got to take a second look to admire that outstanding block.
And that is a huge block, given how close this game is. A stop like that was right on point.
Maxi Kleba, he's checked in for Powell. Carter, he's checked in for the Magic. Here's Doncic. And that one, good. Doncic has got nine.
And when they've gone to him, he has come through big time. You got to keep getting him touches.
Wagner outside. Anthony on the wing. Wagner with a screen for Anthony. It's hauled in by Wood. Wood's got his fourth rebound with that last one here tonight. Here's Hardaway. Still getting warmed up offensively. No scoring yet from him. Oh, a nice defensive play to disrupt the alley-oop. Lets it go from 11. That one off the back iron and out.
I tell you what, the defense should send Christmas cards for that miss.
Doncic dishes to Hardaway. Latrey. Doncic, no good.
Boy, he won't miss many from that spot. The defense gets lucky there.
Anthony finds Wagner. Carter with it. And it's Finney Smith with the rebound.
Well, we love his ability to attack the rim. He just loses a little bit of focus and misses the chippy.
And contact on the shot, so he'll be shooting free throws here. You talk about a defensive menace. That's Dorian Finney-Smith.
He has a knack for coming up with a big defensive play. Often lines up against the opponent's most important offensive player.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
And he knocks down the first one. Offense has become a focal point in the NBA. We know that. And Doris, is there a place still in this league for defensive specialists?
Undoubtedly, Kevin. Look no further than the NBA champion Golden State Warriors. Gary Payton II played that role to a hilt. He made the difference between winning and losing when it mattered most. Elite perimeter defense is always in demand.
He's off on the second.
Boy, what a season 2022 was for the Dallas Mavericks, making it all the way to the Western Conference Finals. Obviously, the huge upset over the Suns turned that season into what was a dream run early in Luka Doncic's career.
And that'll be two free throws coming up. Officials on the call with the foul. And with the Mavs, a trip Doris to the Conference Finals puts them ahead of schedule, many people think.
Yes, Kevin, but I don't think you can let that momentum you built last year fade in any way. You've got to keep your foot on the gas pedal. We know how fragile success in the NBA is. You've got a top five player on your roster. You have to make sure you're taking advantage of opportunities.
And that one misses. And some changes here for the Mavericks. Reggie Bullock, he's checked in for Dorian Finney-Smith. And it's Neal Akina in for Luka Doncic. And the second free throw, good.
And the Magic have been one of the league's worst offenses in recent years. In fact, it's been over a decade since they've been average in that regard. Drafting a ready-made weapon in Paolo Banchero, they hope can help them take a step in the right direction.
The Mavericks have been successful on three of their four free throw attempts up to this point.
Spencer Dinwiddie at the line for two.
Shoot two.
The free throw drops for Dinwiddie.
Yeah.
And both free throws good for Dinwiddie.
As we've gotten closer to halftime, their style has become more and more physical.
Pass to Okiki. A three. The Magic again can hit. Mavericks leading by eight. Here's Ntilikina. Still looking for his first bucket in this one. And there's the call. It's going to be an illegal screen.
Beyond the leaning, you could see his feet more set on that screen. Easy call.
You know, he's just leaning a little bit. You try to get away with it, but boy, the official all over it.
The Magic trail by eight. And here is Harris. Carter with a screen on Dinwiddie. McGee with the block. Here's Ntilikina. And he banks in the layup. Ntilikina's got the lead up to 10 now for the Mavs. And taking a quick look here at the hustle stats for the Mavs.
Their defense has been so aggressive right out of the gate, wasting no time shutting shooters down here with authority.
You've also got to love the way they've been crashing the offensive glass. Multiple opportunities, not giving up on possessions. Beautiful.
Now, here's Dinwiddie. He has five. Pass to Ntilikina. McGee is screened. Shot left block. And it's McGee with the jam.
Well, the more experience Frank Ntilikina gets, the better he looks. What a pretty pass.
1:30 left to play here in the half. McGee against Harris. And the shot is good. The Maverick lead has been cut down now to just 10 points with that basket from Carter.
And they've done well at taking advantage of some late defensive rotations and getting the ball in the paint.
And he gets contact and the whistle on the shot. Two shots coming up. And for Orlando, it's been a tough decade. We would agree on that. And Greg, they've only won two playoff games since 2012.
Well, they've only made the playoffs twice in that span as well. So they've got a lot of draft picks lined up in the next few years, and they need to make good on those high picks.
The first one falls. He's perfect from the line this time.
The way he's shooting free throws tonight, you simply don't want to put him there.
Now Hampton has to Okiki. 59 seconds left here in the second. Here's Carter. Looks good, is good. Bucket number four from the field. He's taken only six shots.
Well, I'll tell you, what a night. He has been efficient. He's been strong. Unfortunately, they're still fighting an uphill battle.
Here's Ntilikina. Fade away. And Carroll grabs the board. Harris looking it over. Carter, the pass to Okiki. Here's Ben Carroll. Counted his second make in four attempts.
And they've had assists now in their last three baskets.
So it's Ntilikina who brings up the ball for the Mavericks. They've held a 12-point lead earlier. There's the pass to Bullock. Shot from the wing. They get it again. McGee. And terrific work on the offensive glass, and he picks up two. McGee's got his third basket of the night. Down low, here's Ben Carroll. And finished off by Ben Carroll.
And didn't do anything fancy there, but didn't need to.
Nope, his only concern right now is getting the points on the board. I don't mean style points. And so it's the Dallas Mavericks in the driver's seat, up 8 points at the end of the quarter. They're pounding the ball inside, and that's where they've gotten their best production tonight. And we've got more M2K Sports coming your way after this break.
Hello and welcome, and what a first half for Cool Hand Luka, Luka Doncic.
In the first half, he was feeling it, not just putting up points, but shooting at a nice clip. I say just keep going to him.
I agree, Kenny. KIS, keep it simple. He's the best player on the floor right now.
And now let's talk about that first half. A look at the top performers from both teams so far.
These guys are leading their way offensively. It's hard work doing all that scoring. Wouldn't you agree with that, Shaq?
Not for me, it wasn't. Piece of cake or barbecue chicken, whichever you prefer. Oh, both at the same time. I'm hungry.
Thanks for spending halftime with us. Time to get it back out to Kevin Harlan for the start of the third quarter.
You have to like what you're seeing from Luka Doncic.
Man, how about the amount he's contributing in the scoring column? Through two quarters, he has been terrific.
And one would expect that the defense made some adjustments at halftime, but he has the ability to answer right back.
The backcourt pair will be Doncic and Dinwiddie. Inside for him, it'll be Finney-Smith and McGee. And it's Bullock in at the small forward. That's the five to begin the second half for Jason Kidd. And here's Wagner after Luka Doncic hitting the three. Passes it to Finney-Smith. Six on the shot clock. To the middle. Here's McGee. And foul on the shot, so he'll get a chance at the line. It's going to be on Wendell Carter.
I mean, even from over here, you can see that one pretty clearly.
The Mavericks have been good at the free throw line. This one, 7 of 8. The first free throw is good. Both free throws good from McGee. The Magic trail by 13. Anthony looking it over. And for those of you tuning in, we're about a minute into the second half. Clock at 6. Wagner with a screen for Ross. And so Orlando again turning it over.
And Berlin native Franz Wagner was only stateside a few years before coming to the NBA.
Well, the beauty about him, though, is Franz has an incredible skill set offensively, and that translates to any language. Consider this guy is a multi-tool player. He can stretch it to deep. He can shoot the mid-range. He's fine around the cup. He'll board it, and he's an excellent playmaker. Boy, this guy can fit in just about anywhere.
Now, here's Bullock. This is the most they've led by, 13 points. Ross on the wing. Shoots over Dinwiddie. That shot off the mark. And the Mavericks going the other way now.
Just a solid performance on the interior. The rebounding has been off the charts.
Bullock passes to Finney-Smith. That shot, no good. Nice defense from Wagner. The Magic trail by 13. No. 2 minutes into the second half of play now. Banchero kicks to Anthony. Pass to Banchero. Wagner from long range. And the rebound goes to the Mavericks. McGee's got 5 rebounds tonight. Pass to Doncic. McGee against Carter. Back to Doncic. Baseline Jay on the way. Score the basket. It's number six for him this game. 6 for 9, 67% shooting.
Well, you can tell the team feeding off Luka Doncic right now. They see him produce. They're just getting him the basketball.
And there's the pass to Bancaro. Yep, that one goes. Bancaro's got 8.
And that solid play in the paint continues here, guys.
And the Mavericks call time here. And as the coaches go to the clipboard to outline their strategy during the timeout, the players getting a chance to rehydrate with some Gatorade. That's key to staying fresh all the way to the final whistle.
And Kevin, it really is. And every one of these players knows it. They're all making sure to stay hydrated. It's impossible to play your A game if you're not getting enough to drink, especially towards the end of games when the physical toll of a long contest really starts to add up.
On the Mavericks with some changes. Dwight Powell's checked in for JaVale McGee. Christian Wood comes in for Reggie Bullock. Hardaway is subbed in for Dinwiddie. Ahmed Bamba, he's checked in for the match. Bull comes in for Bancaro. Finney Smith passes to Doncic. Wood a screen on him. Doncic kicks to Wood. From outside, off the mark.
He is too good a shooter, guys, to be left open like that. The defense just dodged a bullet there.
Doncic against Anthony. And Bamba now top of the key. Ross with it. Passes it to Bull. Shoots from the corner. Rebounded by Hardaway. Mavericks leading by 13. Second half here. We're just over 3.5 minutes into it. The three for Doncic. That shot is off. And so it's Ross. He brings it up for the Orlando Magic. That'll be the second of this two-game road trip. Wagner passes to Ross. And he uses the glass on the layup.
Just no resistance on the inside. That's their fifth consecutive make in the paint.
And here is Hardaway. He's still scoreless so far in this one. Dallas needs to get off a shot. Dallas, no good that time either. The Magic trail by 11. Wagner passes to Anthony. Doris, you have to appreciate how confident Cole Anthony is in his game.
Kevin, I love the swagger this young man plays with. He feels and believes that he can score on anyone at the NBA level. And that kind of attitude is what, to me, makes this guy unguardable. And, Greg, I cannot imagine how proud you are as his father.
Well, Doris, there's no doubt that I'm proud of him. And you're right. He probably does think he can score on just about anybody, even when he can't.
No good on the free throw.
And as I watch Cole out there, Kevin, I just love the progression he's made. The young man's put the work in to improve his game and really only starting to scratch the surface.
Frank Ntilikina has checked in for the Mavericks. Then for the Magic. Okiki's checked in for Franz Wagner. And Harris subbed in for Ross. And he's good on the second.
Cole Anthony, a guy who has just tremendous feel for the game. He's obviously been around him from the time he was very young. Just understands where the ball should be at all times. Good passer, aggressive scorer.
Let's it fly from 18. And with that, the Maverick lead is cut down now to just 8 on the basket from Harris.
Great finish. What a setup. Terrific ball movement there.
For Cole Anthony, GA, this team believes in his future.
I mean, he's a competitive kid and knows how to play the right way. And now he understands how to play winning basketball. That's no bias from me. That's just my analysis.
Now here's Anthony. After Luka Doncic's miss.
A moment to check out Luka Doncic here. He's coming off an excellent season. Put up about 28 points a game, 8 assists, and 9 rebounds. And it's nice to be able to bring someone with his defensive skill set off the bench.
I think, in fact, to win a championship, you usually need a guy like this on your
roster.
Take
a break. Take a break. Two shots.
He misses the free throw. Maxi Kleba, he's checked in for the Mavericks. And that trip coming up empty, missing both.
Boy, that's not the result I would have predicted. Usually you can take those to the bank when he's at the line.
Back to Doncic. They need this one. And Ball pulls it down. The Magic trail by 8. Kicks to Anthony. Pass to Okiki. And here is Harris. Now, here's Bamba. He's gotten some minutes, but nothing on the board yet. We've got 1:13 left in the third. Doncic against Anthony. Pass to Kleba. Let's it go with the three. Good! And the assist goes to Doncic. Doncic has got 3 assists now in this one. The Magic have gone 3 of 7 on field goal attempts here in the second half. Bamba, a screen on Doncic. And Anthony gets it to go.
The real. Come at us, and we're coming right back at you.
And you would expect nothing less from these two, taking pride and making plays.
Now, here's Doncic. He's got 14. Yes, that goes in.
And not quite as aggressive from outside as they were in the first half. Sticking to the high percentage shots, playing smart with the lead.
Harris against Hardaway. Outside Anthony. Solid shot from the distance of about 14 feet. Anthony's got 6 here in this quarter.
Boy, tough shot for a young player. No hesitation in the mid-range by Cole Anthony.
And finished off by Wood.
And let the big man eat. Throw it up to Wood, and he'll complete that.
Outside Anthony. Nice D from Doncic.
I'll tell you, everything went right in terms of execution. He just can't get it to go.
And so it's Dallas with a 10-point lead. Some breathing room heading into the break. They've played the better game so far, but their work is far from over. We'll get right back to the action when we return. How about a look at today's State Farm assist of the game?
And he sliced the D wide open with his feet. They had no chance to prevent that basket.
Well, that's what a great pass will do, right? You love the unselfish play.
Quarter of action is upon us. Thanks as always for joining us. On the court for Orlando, in the post, it's Banchero and Carter Jr. Hampton out there with Terrence Ross, and it's Wagner in at the 3, the small forward. Now here is Carter. Misses the mark, his 3rd miss of the game, 4 for 7 now.
It's a +5 advantage for them in rebounding after that one.
Dinwiddie outside. The pass to Wood. And finished off by Wood.
And there's a lot of power behind Woods' dunks. He's not going to get cheated when he takes it to the rim.
Now Hampton. Passes it to Carter. Inside. Here's Ben Carroll. And foul on the shot. He'll shoot 2 at the free throw line. And guys, what do you think about the offensive approach we've seen so far for the Mavericks?
I mean, they've been stepping it up in terms of their shooting from distance, and the confidence has been there all game long, leaving the defense to scramble.
I also like how they've played in the painted area. They've made an effort to work on the inside and convert those chances.
That free throw, good from Bancaro. And the Mavericks making a change here. Bullock's checked in, and the Magic making a change here as well. Anthony's checked in for Hampton. Good on both.
And they came out of the locker room after halftime with a much more physical approach than what we saw in that first half.
Now, here's Dinwiddie. Wood in the post. Harder on him. Yep, it counts. And the Mavericks lead by 12.
Yeah, that was the third straight high percentage look the defense has allowed. The defenders have got to start putting bodies on bodies.
That was a second look at our Mobile One drive. Amazing control on display.
And the awareness of his footwork and body on that drive. Wow.
About a minute and a half through the fourth quarter now. Ross against Hardaway. Ross kicks to Anthony. Off the mark there with the three-point shot.
And they've got a big lead, not just on the scoreboard, but really in the rebounding numbers as well.
Dinwiddie outside. Back to Hardaway. All alone. That one falls coming off Dinwiddie's feet. Dinwiddie's got three assists in the game. And so it's Ross. He brings it up for Orlando. It's a 14-point game. Pass to Anthony. Wagner, a screen on Dinwiddie. They get the rebound. And block. That one goes careening off the glass. To the inside. Finney Smith. And he gets the whistle. Two free throws coming up. It's on Paolo Bancaro.
That's what we call a high-effort play by Dorian Finney-Smith. Takes it right to the defense and gets the whistle.
Two shots.
That one is off.
Well, probably a little draft in the arena tonight. He's the last guy you expect to miss the mark by that much.
Absolutely. And the Mavericks making a change here. McGee's checked in. He hits the second from the line.
Guys, I think what you have to love about Dorian Finney-Smith is his versatility. Skill set-wise, you can play him at either forward position, and in either spot, he's going to give you tremendous defensive effort.
Now here's Anthony. And the layup's good off the glass.
And he's showing signs now of life after going scoreless through the half.
Dallas leading by 13. Dinwiddie surveying the floor. Anthony against Hardaway. Over Anthony. Hardaway, no good. For Orlando, they've gone 1-5 from the field here in the fourth. A lot of misses, just the one make. Here is Ross. Outside Anthony, and Carter has it in the corner. No good on the triple. For Dallas, they've gone 3-5 here in the fourth quarter. Pretty good numbers coming out of the break. Outside Hardaway. Pass to Bullock. Beyond the arc. Bancaro grabs the board. Bancaro's got four rebounds in this game. Ross against Dinwiddie. Outside Anthony. Carter sets the pick for Anthony. Stolen away. Dinwiddie against Ross. Solid play in the low block, and that one's good. And the Mavericks lead by 15.
When you allow good scorers to get uncontested shots at the rim, no wonder you're losing.
To me, this has simply stated been a complete lack of defensive attention and focus all night long.
Now, here's Bancaro.
Flying high and throwing it down with the one hand.
One of his favorite moves right there, guys. And he lobs it up toward the rim. It's stolen by Carter. Outside Anthony. Carter with a screen on Hardaway. Goes up the baseline. That's in, and the Dallas lead has got down to 11 on the bucket from Anthony.
Pick works well there. Not much resistance from the D.
It takes incredible effort to stay connected to the hip of the offensive player. You've got to want to work.
Now here is Hardaway.
2 minutes.
And a lot of contact on that one, so he'll shoot two here. It's on Paolo Banchero.
It's proving very difficult to guard Tim Hardaway Jr. without fouling the guy, especially when he's this aggressive.
Tim Hardaway Jr. at the line for two.
And the first one at the line is good. Greg, you have to love the impact that Tim Hardaway Jr. has had on the defensive end.
He's got a great wingspan to bother shooters and contain penetration. Always aware of where the ball is on the floor. You could call him an underrated defender.
Luka Doncic, he's checked in for Reggie Bullock. Hardaway hits them both.
You see, to me, guys, for Tim Hardaway Jr., there's still another level for him to reach. He has proven that he can be a big-time scorer. To me now, it's about consistency and doing it night after night after night.
Now here's Anthony. No good on that one. Nice D from Doncic. And so it's Doncic with it. He brings it up for the Dallas Mavericks. Giving up just 8 points in the fourth quarter. Dallas again missing. The Magic trail by 13. Ross with it. Outside Anthony. Wagner with a screen for Anthony. And off the left side of the rim, and it swirls in for him. Anthony's got 12 points here in the second half. Dallas leading by 11. Doncic right side. Out to the right wing. Some nice passing here by Dallas. Shot clock at 6. McGee is screen on him. Always going up for the alley-oop here. And the slam dunk by McGee.
And these are the types of games where one team clearly has the edge. Tonight, it will be a win by a large margin for the Mavericks.
They had a fantastic play from the bench.
And this team has great depth, and they showed it in this game.
And every win important, and this one will go down as win number 3.
And so they'll take the first game of the season series, a team they'll only see twice. They're certainly happy to start it off with a win.
And one of the league's top talents, game in and game out. And doing it here again in this one. A terrific night for Luka Doncic.
This guy has been shot-making all night long. He commands the rock and takes over.
Here's Anthony. And it's Anthony again missing. Confident play we're seeing out of him.
Yeah, and the scoreboard tells the story.
Here now is Dinwiddie. So we see the Mavericks taking the win here. some good moments throughout this one, but they had the clear advantage down the stretch.
Yeah, I mean, I love the way they executed on both ends of the floor, completely under control for the vast majority of the game. And whenever there was a misstep, they just didn't allow it to fester, and that's why they're going to walk away with the win.
And now we'll go to David Aldridge, who's standing by with our player of the game. Take it away, David.
Thanks, Kevin. Luka, you played well and you got the win. So what made the difference?
Yeah, I think we had a great game. You know, we had I think it was a great game today. You know, we step up together, play good defense, and it was a great win.
Thanks for your time, man. Appreciate it. Kevin, back to you.
David, thank you as always. And that's going to do it tonight, folks, for our broadcast. For Greg Anthony, Doris Burke, and David Aldridge, this is Kevin Harlan saying thanks for tuning in. As New Balance presents our player of the game, Luka Doncic.